Pakistani side, the legal team continues to say there are questions that are left unanswered by the Indian legal team, and that is essentially about why was a different name used for the Indian passport.
Now, the reason why those questions were put to the Indian side was to further strengthen the argument that this person was not merely a person who was a private person and hired as a spy, paid to gain information, but he was actually an official of a state. So when you are an official of a state, then everything that you do is attributable to that state. Now, that's very serious under international law. That's where the state responsibility of those individual acts of crime, offences, terrorism, shifts to the shoulders of the state. And that is what India is fearing that Pakistan is trying to establish. That is why they are giving no answers to that.
But India's countered, hasn't it, by claiming that Jadhav was actually kidnapped from Iran and not found within Pakistan.
Frankly, the arrest of an accused is irrelevant from any jurisdiction. It does not absolve him from the crime that he admits to have committed. That's the law in the US. People are taken outside from the US, through any means brought into US. When they are tried, they take similar defenses. Those defenses are turned down. So I don't know what's the fact in one sense, but whether he's arrested from Balochistan or wherever, he has admitted that he was perpetuating acts of terrorism on the instructions of the state of India. And based on that information, a separate FIR has been also registered, which was mentioned yesterday mm-hmm. in the pleadings by the Indian side as well. Mm-hmm. In that FIR, the network that he was addressing has been talked about, and then Pakistan writes a letter to the government of India saying, look, he takes these following names. We would like to take statements. We would like to have their version. Mm-hmm. India stalls that process as well.
Doesn't respond, essentially.
Doesn't respond. And the reason it doesn't respond is if it does, then the responsibility for intervention is that on India. So this is not a small thing. And these judges who are sitting in the ICJ are all specialists of international law. They understand the sanctity of the principle of non-intervention.